The editor window is the heart of the Microkorg editor, and here's...
We interrupt this program for an update.
What? Already?
Yes, after 14 years the PC editor got an update, a version 2, that you can download from Korg's website. There's a version 2 for the Mac as well. And hey, did you see that? There's also a bunch of sounds. Nice! The main reason for the update was that the editor has to deal with the doubled memory of the Microkorg S. And there are some minor changes in its graphic appearance, but nothing of importance. They both work equally well on my Windows 10 laptop and on my old XP computer. Not bad. In the meantime, there's also a third-party editor developed that you can buy, but I will describe Korg's editor. Talking about updates, checking for updates for your MIDI device might be more important, to avoid the dreaded Midi-error. Nobody? Well, everybody who tries the editor knows these errors. So, to give you courage, I'll show you my troubles. But first... A tip from some of my viewers is to turn the MIDI clock on the Microkorg from intern to extern. I thought that was to enslave him to the rhythm of the computer, but this attractive model proved not real, as we shall see. But more important, setting the clock to extern works. For me at least. On my laptop, the MIDI port 2.2 doesn't work on one of the USB ports. Errors follow... and the MIDI setting fields are empty. Now I try the other port and... failure again. But perseverance. Cause now I can set the MIDI ports from the default A... you can't see it, the fields are too short... to my preferred B port, which are comfortably at the back side of the device. And... woohoo! My Focusrite Sapphire works fine, but chokes on that same USB port too. On my old XP computer, my Audigy card gave trouble too. The MIDI settings must be redirected to MIDI IO2. Somewhat illogical, cause these are the only normal MIDI ports. After that, it seemed to work, but these are phony idlers, as I call them, and will explain later. Then, after clicking the MK icon again, it suddenly works, even writing the patches to the synth. I just don't understand it. But the MIDI port 2.2 works without even installing the drivers. Well, how about that? When things don't work, check also the status of the push button of the MIDI port. I once pressed it out by accident and searched a long time for errors that weren't there. And finally, I must mention the MIDI aux program that can be very helpful. If you know how to use it. You might get the impression that MIDI is misery. But of course it is not. MIDI is fun. It's one of the best things that ever happened in synthesizer world. But what is MIDI? We will see that in the more optimistic part 2B, after leaving this somewhat troubled movie.